No, he said, I'm jealous.
What?
I'm jealous of your aunt. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Bye. I don't care who Michael Ellis is.
We must have all this damn eggs with the iron boot of Protestant England.
Excuse me, I was in the anger counter.
Pit of them all this damn eggs with the iron boot of Protestant enlightenment.
Would it not the Lord himself have said, stamp out the papal sway?
Will Mr. Michael Ellis please go straight to the manager's office? I'll repeat that. Will Mr. Nigel Mellish please go straight to the manager's office?
What you got now?
I bought an ant, Mother.
Oh, devil. What do you want one of them for? I'm not going to clean it out. You said you'd clean the tiger out, but do you? No, I suppose you lost interest in it now. Now it'll be ant, ant, ant for a couple of days. Then all of a sudden, oh, Mum, I've bought a sloth or some other odd-toed ungulate like a tapir.
No, it's really different this time, Mum. I'm really going to look after this ant.
That's what you said about the sperm whale. Why, Pop was having to use it as a gouge.
Well, you didn't feed it properly.
Where are we going to get 44 tons of plankton from every morning? Your Papa was dead vexed about that. He thought he was mad in the deli.
Well, at least he's got a free garage.
Right, no good to him. His Hillman smells all fishy. Oh, blimey, there's a tiger. He'll be watched his bandies.
Are you giving that tiger drugs?
Of course I'm giving it drugs.
It's illegal.
You try telling that to the tiger.
Well, I think it's dangerous.
Listen, before he started fixing, he used to get through 4 Jehovah's Witnesses a day. And he used to eat all of them, except for the pamphlets.
Well, he's not dim.
All right!
Well, I think I'll go and watch one of the televisions. Come on, Marcus.
Oh, by the way, Michael's been on the phone all day for you.
Michael?
Hello, Michael. Michael Ellis. Yeah, he's been on the phone all day. He came around twice.
What's he look like?
Oh, I didn't see him. The orange rubtigooty answered the door. Only useful animal you ever bought, that.
Where is he now?
He's upstairs forging prescriptions for the sodding tiger.
No. Where's Michael Ellis now?
Oh, I don't know. He said it wasn't important anyway. All right, here I come.
Hello and welcome to the University of the Air. And first this afternoon, part 17 of our series on animal communications. This afternoon, we look at recent discoveries in the field of intraspecific signaling codes in the family Formisoidae.
Oh, that's a stroke of luck, Marcus.
Announcement. And now back to University of the Air and our series for advanced medical students, Elements of Surgical Homeopathic Practice. Part 68, Ants.
Oh, we're in luck again, Marcus.
Hello, former citophiles. Well, before all the blood and guts you're waiting to see, let's have a look at the anatomy of the little ant.
The body of the ant is divided into three sections. The head, the thorax, and the abdomen. They're enclosed in a hard, armor-like covering called the exoskeleton, which provides some protection from other nasty little insects. But unfortunately, not from the dissector's scalpel.
See? Nothing to it. He's not such a toughie. And his legs, they help him carry hundreds of times his own weight. But look at this. They're not so strong compared to me. 4, 5, 6.
I didn't know ants had 6 legs, Marcus.
I assure you they do, Mr. Ellis.
Hey, you've got 2 legs missing. And that's a false feeler, Marcus. Blimey. Taking this ant back, Mother. It's got 2 legs missing.
Mrs. McWong's been on the phone. The polar bear's been in our garden again.
Well, look, I'll get it on the way back from the store.
Well, mind you do. His droppings are enormous. Oh, and by the way, while you're out, get us another couple of terriers, would you? Here's 180 quid.
Second floor, stationery, leather goods, nasal injuries, cricket bats, film stars, dolphinariums. Third floor, cosmetics, books, Irish massage, tribal headgear, ants. But not complaints about ants.
Oh, where do I go to complain?
Straight on, then left, then right past the thing, then up the little stairs, then right past the bit where it's gone all soft, then down the wobbly bit, left past the nail, past the brown stain on the wall to your right, and the door marked exit straight ahead of you on the left.
Thank you.
Fourth.
I don't want you.
Oh, something wrong with your little ant friend?
No, I'm not going to tell you.
Oh, what you got? Something missing in the leg, department?
No. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Can I help you, sir?
No.
Oh, it's all right, sir. It's for the sack race later on, sir.
No. I want to speak to the general manager. I want to complain.
Oh, well, you want the toupee hall in that case, sir?
The what?
The toupee hall, Mr. Ellis.
Excuse me, could you tell me the way to the toupee hall, please?
Sorry?
The toupee hall.
The what?
The toupee hall.
Oh, the toupee hall. Gladys?
Yes?
Where are toupees now?
Toupees?
Mm, this gentleman wants one.
A toupee?
Mm.
Well, no, actually.
Oh, I think they're in surgical appliances now.
Oh, that's right. Yes, you go left at artificial limbs and hearing aids, right at dentures, and it's on your left just by glass eyes. It doesn't say toothpaste to avoid embarrassing people, but you can smell them.
Thank you.
You can see the join.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's so nice to see such a large turnout this afternoon. And I'd like to start off by welcoming our guest speakers for this afternoon, Mr. Wordsworth. Mr. John Coutts and Percy Bysshe.
Shelley.
Oh, just a little one, medium dry. And Alfred Lord.
Tennis ball.
Son. Sorry, Alfred Lord, who is evidently Lord Tennis Ball's son. And to start off, I'm going to ask Mr. Wadsworth to recite his latest offering, a little pram entitled I Wandered Lonely as a Crab. And it's all about ants.
I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden worker ants.